Hey guys, I am here with the lovely Brenna Odell, and we are getting ready to do a color gel fashion photo shoot. She's got great makeup here by Brenda Flores, so we're really gonna highlight that and do some really fun stuff. But I will say this, whenever you do a shoot with a model, it's good to for you and the model to have a rapport, to have, so there's gotta be some comfort level there. So a lot of times I try to come up with some kind of fun icebreaker. And I cannot think of a better way to break the ice than to make up a cool handshake, right? So let's try it. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's try this, ready? Backhand, forehand, and Zoolander, and then.
I don't think so.
What?
Mm-mm.
Fine, let's just take some pictures. So let's take a look at the lighting setup we've got today. We got quite a few lights. Let's start here with the key light. We're using a beauty dish here, about a 22-inch beauty dish. We've got a grid in this dish to keep the light from spilling off to the sides too much. Anytime we do these color gelled shoots, we like to really control where the light's going. We also have a gel in there that's kind of a skin tone softening gel, because this is going to be the main key light on the model's face. All right, the next light we have is our fill light from down below to fill in the lower parts of the image, to fill in under the chin just a little bit, right? To add a little extra light. We're using a gold reflector with some orange gels over top of the light because we really want a nice warm light coming in. We also have two edge lights, and we're gonna use two different colors to create a real nice aesthetic on her hair and on the sides of her face. The first one that we're using is a 40 degree grid in a 7-inch parabolic dish. And then we also have this reddish pinkish gel over here to give us a really cool color highlight. All right, our other edge light is also a 7-inch parabolic dish. We have a 20 degree grid in that, so we want that light to spill a little bit less. That's gonna tighten the pattern on that. And we've got a purple to complement the pink color on the other side. And last but not least, we have a background light. We have a nice dark red gel here, and we're shining against a black cloth background. That'll give us a really cool but dark red tone to set off the entire picture. And sometimes when you're doing a shoot, you want to find other elements and things that create cool background textures, maybe create some reflections. So I happened to be just walking through Lowe's the other day and saw this in one of the aisles. And this thing is awesome. You're gonna see as we shoot the pictures how it grabs the color from the edge lights, and it also creates an interesting texture behind the model. And of course, no self-respecting fashion shoot would be complete without a fog machine. You always wanna throw something in there you can try, because when you're doing color gels and you run fog into the air, man, sometimes it catches the light in the coolest ways. So we're gonna use that today too. We'll try some with, we'll try some without. All right, for this shoot, I decided to go with f2.8. That's gonna give me some fall off, but not too much fall off, because we have some beautiful makeup work that we wanna capture, and I don't want that to fall off too much and be lost in the shot. So when I set it at 2.8 to get the ambient exposure where I wanted, I had to go to ISO 100 and shoot at 1/200, because at f2.8 we're pretty wide open, and we did turn off the lights in here, the overhead lights, but still have window lights, so I wanted to make sure it got nice and dark, so my lights did all the work and there was no ambient interfering with the color. Today I'm using one of my absolute all-time favorite portrait lenses, and that is the Canon 85mm f1.2. Now, we're not going to use f1.2 like I said before, but this lens is very sharp, has beautiful fall off, and works fantastic for portraits. I would highly recommend it. All right, guys, now we have the lights set up. We're ready to rock. Let's go ahead and get some shots and take a look. Yeah, so that looks really cool. That looks really cool. All right, so you can see what we did here. We used edge lighting to light the sides of her face. We used a background light to light against the red, the black, to give it a red color. And then we also have this bounce over here that we talked about that's lighting, sending kind of a goldish tone, soft light through. And then we also have an overhead light here with a nice soft diffused skin tone gel on that as well. So we're getting a fantastic look there, guys. We're gonna have her turn to the side here so we can take a look at the wonderful makeup work that was done by Brenda Flores. You can check her out at Baja by Brenda on Instagram. All right, so let's grab this shot. Beautiful, beautiful, right? If we zoom in on this shot, guys, we can see all the highlights. that we've got here. We can see the makeup very, very cleanly and very clearly. The beautiful jewels over the eyebrows. Looks fantastic. All right, so as you can see, we can do a lot of really cool things when we use gel lighting in our photo shoots. So I encourage you to try different things. You know, try different colors, use different lighting setups, but don't be afraid to put yourself out there and create a piece of art. It takes time, it takes work. We didn't get to this setup like that, right? What you don't see on camera is that we went in here and we tried a bunch of different things until we got this exactly the way we wanted it. So get out there, keep shooting, be creative, and never ever be afraid to try. I can't think of a better icebreaker than a cool handshake. All right, let's make up a cool handshake. You ready?
Okay, you I'm good? Following your lead.
Okay, ready? So first backhand, then across, then Zoolander, like that, and then... Oh my gosh, she's gonna do it! We were hoping you would react. I actually spit on my hand.